might have driven into the lock gate.
Does anyone know any welders? What do I do? I need saving. I'm stuck.
Welcome to Cruising Alba.
We invite you to join us on our adventure living off-grid and travelling the UK canal network. I'm Miles.
And I'm Marina.
Last week, we spent a few days in one spot, enjoying the beauty of Lechlade, went swimming with swans, and got a few boat tasks ticked off, including making a bathroom door.
Excuse me, cow.
We need a welder.
We need to stop crashing. Mate. Have you ever seen the film Titanic?
I don't think Titanic went through any bridges.
No.
Low bridges.
We'll do it for now.
Today's our last day here. Since I've been exploring the area for the past few days and I know where to go, I'm taking the opportunity to go for the last run. Behind me is the roundhouse, which used to be a lockkeeper's house, and it stands exactly where the Thames and Severn Canal meets River Thames. This canal is no longer operational, and at the moment it's undergoing reconstruction.
I'm not sure if we can get through, there are cars in the way. I'm stuck. Okay, I'm going in. Shoo, shoo. Let me get through. Shall I get a stick? Now I've got the stick. I'm going to try to use a selfie stick. Coming through. What do I do? I need saving. I'm stuck. Are you trying to eat it? Yeah, I'm here. I don't know, do they kick? Coming through, yes! Oh god, look how many of them! That was close. Hey, cows, I'll miss you. Yeah, I will.
We've just put out the watermelon outside. Miles kindly chopped it for the cows. I think I've also left an aubergine, but it's still there. I don't think I've been cooking with you guys for a while, so I thought I'll show you how I make a creamy, plant-based leek and potato soup. I'm glad they like potatoes.
Welcome to my cooking show, Cooking with Cows.
Yes, you are the star of the show.
You've got stars in your nose as well.
How many of you are here for potatoes?
You're gonna share? One cow eats all.
Don't fight here.
What if it's just gonna go through the window? Hopefully not. Maybe it wasn't such a good idea to put it this close. I'm learning every day. Vegan batter. We are about to set off. I'm really excited. We haven't been for a cruise in over a week. But before I do that, I am going to attach this sticker to the front of the boat. If you remember, a couple of weeks ago, I accidentally kicked in the GoPro in the lock. So now I'm going to make sure that it is attached properly. Solid.
Hopefully it should be quicker on the way back.
Bye, cows. I will miss you. I will miss those cows so much.
There was a player in every corner doing tricks for a dime. All the streets were cold.
At least we gave him a good lunch today.
Bright shining silver and gold.
It's fun getting to know the cows, don't think? So we fixed the Buddha's head, but if it falls off again, we can always put one of the little lights in it.
What do you guys think of the Father Thames?
This statue was commissioned in 1854. It used to be located right at the beginning of the river. And in the 70s, it was moved to St. John's Lock here.
The luck is on our side today. We just found bins and we've got quite a lot of recycling.
Lo and behold, you had your eyes on all the bright shining silver. If only you could show me silver and gold. Oh, you didn't need no reason more than the oh so pleasing.
All we need now is to get some water and we're sorted.
And when all is fair, just say a prayer. Cause win or losing matters just the same. Just say a prayer. Cause we are all in it for the oh. It's time went by so slowly. If only he could show me silver and gold. Oh.
This is Kelmscott.
We're going to Kelmscott village nearby and we've been recommended to visit it.
We are going to see Kelmscott Manor. It's a farmhouse that was built in around 1600s.
What did you find?
Pillbox. Go on, see it. There's nothing scary in here.
Okay. Just for you guys.
Cool. So this is a pillbox.
Unfortunately, the manor was closed as it's currently being restored.
Shame. We are setting off tonight. kind of fence is that?
Would it look like a stone wall when it was originally done?
What's your estimate? Years?
300.
We've just seen a U2 spy plane fly over.
How do you know it's U2?
Because I'm clever and I googled it. It's a reconnaissance and surveying plane, high altitude.
We have been seeing quite a few military planes lately, and the reason is because there are many RAF bases in Oxfordshire. Not all of them are operational though. And the largest of them all, Bryce Norton, is also located somewhere in the area. Won't you stay?
So Marina's gone to rescue our pot. You can't see them on here, but we had a pot with three sunflowers literally days away from blooming. We've had them for months. But luckily I noticed, and Marina kindly volunteered to go and get them. I try and keep the boat steady.
So we managed to save the sunflowers. Well done for not seeing.
Well done for getting them.
We found a water point. They look very different here on the Thames, so we never know what to look for. And this time it was in a cupboard. So here is a small dilemma with laundry. Best way to do laundry is when the engine is on. We don't want to run the engine unnecessarily extra, obviously. Then the most economical time to do laundry is when we're cruising, when the engine is already on. The second factor is water. We are just filling up our tank, so we're going to have enough water for laundry, which I haven't done for about 2 weeks. It is long overdue. Sorry for the noise, this is our gas heater for water. And another thing is, when you are doing laundry and you're not cruising, you've got to choose the day when it's really sunny and everything dries really quickly. Obviously you kind of want to do it then, however, because there aren't that many sunny lovely days, the last thing you want to do is do laundry, because you want to go out and do things, or I don't know, just enjoy the sunshine. So there is never a perfect day to do laundry. And I think I'm going to do ours now.
So we ran out of wraps. So making a fajita sandwich. Got rice on here, cheese, fajitas, avocado, and yeast flavouring, mayo bread bun.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's pretty damn good.
It's the best sandwich you've ever had.
Up there.
When your life's been put on hold for far too long, when the sorrow and despair is growing strong.
I've got a new batch of kombucha. I made this one on Red Bush tea, and I desperately need a new container, new jar for the SCOBY, because it is now so big. I don't know where to buy them from, and I don't know where to deliver it to. That's probably the main reason why I still don't have one.
All we need to do is search within.
Everything seemed to go well that day, until...
Might have driven into the lock gate, and by the looks of it, it was quite hard as well.
I was in the paddle, so I was on the side, and the boat crashed into the lock door, and it seemed pretty hard, but then there's some paint left in the lock door, so I thought, oh, that's weird, and then here it is. Looks like the metal split. Well, it didn't go through, so that's positive. Sorry, Alba, I didn't mean to do that. Maybe we can fix it somehow. Does anyone know any welders? This tree reminds me of a tree that we have at home in Russia. Is it wisteria? If I ever live in a house, then I'd love to have this tree in my garden. It smells amazing. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to follow along our journey. A huge thanks to our amazing Patreons who help to make this episode happen every week. If you would like to see bonus content, watch these episodes early, consider joining us on Patreon. Tune in next week for more cruising, new friends, and a new haircut for Miles. Thanks guys, see you in the next one. Yeah, you pull me up when I'm falling down.